You are probably familiar with fixed update loop, but you are not really sure how to use it. Some people told you that it's a slower version of an update loop, which is not true. You always have to think, should I put my code inside an update loop or a fixed update loop? In other tutorials, you were told to write your code inside a fixed update loop, but you never really understood why you are doing that. If you are that guy, then watch this video and don't forget to subscribe. Before we can understand how fixed update loop works, we need to understand how objects traverse an area. I'm pretty sure you have no idea how that works under the hood, so let me explain. In video games, objects move by frame rate. If we set object speed to 1 unit, then the object will move at 1 unit per frame. If our game frame rate is 60 frames per second, then in 1 second we will move 60 units. Sounds simple, right? Well, not really. The issue with this is that if we use a different machine with lower specs, and let's say that machine can reach max 40 frames per second, that object will only move 40 units per second, and the game experience will not be the same on different machines. But programmers have come up with solutions to solve this problem. It's called DeltaTime. In Unity, it is called time.DeltaTime. And if you're not familiar with it, I have a tutorial on the same topic and you can watch it here. But now let's see how it solves the problem. If our speed is set to 1 unit and our frame rate is 60 frames per second, we take that 1 unit and we divide it by our frame rate. It will return a time step that is used to reach destination. In 1 second, we will move 1 unit. A machine that runs on 60 frames and a machine that runs on 40 frames will reach destination at the same time. And that is how we fix the issue when we move by frame on different machines. But actually, there's another issue with this approach. While this solution does work, it may not be perfect in every scenario. As in previous example, we have two machines, one that runs on 60 frames and other that runs on 40 frames. Objects on both machines will reach destination at the same time, which is ideal, right? But the issue is how they reach the destination. Because of the difference in the frame rate, they have different time steps. Machine 1 that runs on 60 frames per second has a time step 1 divided by 60 equal 0.016 units per frame. Machine 2 that runs on 40 frames per second has a time step 1 divided by 40 equals 0.025 units per frame. So it is possible for them to not move in exact same frame. They will reach the final destination in the same frame, but they will not get to the final destination in matching frames. So what is the issue? Well, in a multiplayer game, this can be a huge issue. Your player and an enemy will not appear in the same frame and experience will be broken for players on different machines. But don't worry, programmers have also solved this problem. And that is exactly what we are going to talk in the next step. To solve the problem with inconsistent movement, programmers have come up with fixed update or fixed time step. It guarantees that any code called inside a fixed update will be called at a fixed time step. In Unity, by default, that time step is 0.02 seconds. It is completely independent from the frame rate. Any machine on any frame rate is going to take exactly 0.02 seconds. They will reach final destination at the same time, but also they will traverse in the same frame towards the final destination. So that's exactly why fixed update exists. It ensures that movement is consistent. In Unity, fixed update is a part of Unity's physics engine. It's recommended to use it together with a rigid body. But one more thing I want to add. While this is a good solution, it's still not perfect for multiplayer games because players can cheat easily. So most multiplayer games have their own custom tick rate, which runs on the server and not on your local machine, and that prevents players from cheating. If you are eager to learn more, I offer one-on-one paid mentorships for new Unity developers and you can check out the link in the description. For those who are not interested but still want to learn, I have a free Discord server that you can join. See the link in the description. Whenever you're not sure when to put your code inside an update loop or a fixed update loop, follow these rules. If you are using built-in physics like a rigid body, use a fixed update. For anything else, use an update. If you need to register user input like a keyboard or a gamepad, then use an update loop. A golden rule is to separate your input from your movement into an update and fixed update loops. If you just follow these rules, you are good to go. This is it, guys. Thank you for watching the video and see you in the next one, and don't forget to subscribe.